Thank you for your patience. So the last two. So and we have like six connectors from the if transport, and three connectors are from the heads. We need to gently push through this hole. Pass through. Last one. Next one from Rupert's head, and the last one from playback head. Okay, it's got the wrong direction, I need to turn it up to help and assist. Okay, we have it removed, as you see. So we don't need the body. Now, I believe the only thing I would do, I would clean up this mess this guy did here. So I will use isopropyl. To remove this sticky residue they put here. Japanese guys, you did bad job, really. See what you did. You did actually more job for me than it was. Okay, see? We have cleaned it up. Now I will remove this part of the deck. I don't need it now. And we will switch to the disassembly tape transport. So let me put it closer. Like that. And we will disassemble this guy here. Okay. Oops, I'm sorry. It's tripod. Take some space. So see what they did? So this guy used some spray. As you may see, it's everything sprayed up with some glue residue. That's why speed was floating. And this belt either, so we would need to replace this and clean up everything. It's ridiculous. I prefer they do nothing about it. It's not a fix. Okay, at least they didn't do any additional harm. All parts are here. So we can gently disassemble. So Let's remove direct drive controller. I'm not sure how to show you better. Okay, like that should be good. You see, for all the screws I had to use a different screwdriver with a smaller number just to make sure that we would gently work with the screws. Okay, so here is the controller. Maybe if I need to clean it up easier. So they spray it everything. I'll use clean brush. To clean up this board. You need to do your work gently because these coils has a very thin wire. Okay, that's enough for now. Let me clean it up. Let's take a look what they did with the belt. Come on. It's a sticky residue. It's not a belt anymore. Let me make more light here. So, see yourself. It's sticky. It sticks to my fingers. See? So it's completely gone there. Next part, you see on every capstan there should be a thin oil filter. I don't see it here, so we'll just pull them up for cleaning. It's capstan number one. Come on, my fingers just stick to it. It's just crazy what they did. Here they did the same thing with this belt, so it's gonna be the feather. So that was a ridiculous noise I was hearing from the deck, that something sticking. I didn't realize what it was. You need to clean it well, really well, until the last sign of residue guns, otherwise it will be doing wow of fluttering, and that's what we like to avoid with all the price. Okay. This one looks to be clean now. I'm pulling up the second capstan. You see, so this is FC coil. Aye, it's sticky. I don't like the feeling. Really. So they just opened the deck to use couple drops of glue to sell it. Make sure, oh, it's running. Otherwise, like it was not running, right? Versus replace two belts. They did more work, really. Clean everything up, take some time. My fingers are sticky with this thing. Let's use clean clothes. Do more isopropyl. Okay, it's not sticky anymore. That's a good sign. Next important part is to deoxidize this potentiometer to make sure that it will successfully work for multiple years. This will dry up, so it's not need cleaning, it will just dry up itself. It's a clean product. So, next piece. We have to clean this gears. I don't feel any more glue here. Let's clean the axle for the common gear, and here this belt is gun eraser. It's sticky. Let's clean the gears. Now, when we will install these two windows and this in between, should look up or north when door is closed. So make sure when you will install it, it will be installed it in the proper direction, otherwise you wouldn't be able to tune deck up, because this potentiometer connected with two adjustment potentiometers, and like they have a range where you can adjust. If you will install it not properly, it will not give you good position. Next part, we need assemble everything back. So to assemble capstans, I will use this oil for sewing machines. From my experience, it's the best oil, it doesn't dry up. So what I will do, you see this part works with the tape, so I will put some oil just right here, because we have a brass bearing here and we'd like to have to work smooth. See, now it's rotate free. Same with this capstan. Put oil here. Shouldn't be any friction. I should run smoothly. Good. Now let me see what belt size you will use. I need to get to my drawer, sorry for a moment, to pull instrument. So this belt is 116, but it's old weld, so probably I will use 109 millimeters. Oh no, it's 120, yeah. 116 should be good for this part. And this one, 45 millimeters in diameter. Okay, let me check my belts. This one is 116, this should work. Let me check for the bigger guy. Okay, here is a 45. I hope it will work. You can try a little bit less, just for the case. Okay, I have 42 and 40. Let me see which one we will use. I will use a drop of oil for this thing, because I clean it up everything. So it will seems irritate now. Let's measure 42. Well, I believe it sits very well. It doesn't sleep. So 42 it is. And good tension. I will remove this one. As I told you, we need to set it up. So it would sit in properly. And we will screw it from this side. This smaller screw. Let me see now. This is not. This guy's. You see, the gear is moving when I rotate the command wheel. So, install it properly. Now, I pull back this guy. Okay, I want to assemble in this order. No. Now we'll put install new belt. Which would not sleep anymore. You see, it stays steady still, not going back and forth, and everything runs smoothly, and tension is good. Let me show it closer. Sorry, I forget that camera was moved. So here I will zoom in. We have installed the command gear. If we will move it, we will see that gears moves here on the lower side, and we installed this belt with good tension, and when we roll in, you see it doesn't move. It looks like stays still. It's a very good quality belt. I pretty much like them. Now, we will assemble everything in the reverse order. So let me see. This piece goes here. This guy goes on top. Now we have this set. We may install screws. Should be looking up straight. That's it. Okay, here we go. It works. Assemble screws. So now we can use zip ties to put all wires in the proper position so it would not get in touch with the belts. So I will use the small one, gentle. Okay, they succeeded with this part. What else I would like to do? We have here is the switches, which work for records protection, chrome tape, and the last one for metal tape. So we need to deoxidize them as well, so they work smoothly without issues. Now we'll use it like that to avoid it spilling into the belts. Next part. We need to check idler condition and clean it up. So what I will do, I will use this chair to open cassette well. Opposite direction. Like that. So let me see, pinch rollers. Looks to be okay. Heads are in a good shape. So remember, we still have to clean up capstans from the oil, just to make sure that no oil will get onto the heads of tape. We'll use isopropyl. And I will rotate capstans to clean them up. Okay, it's cleaned. Next step is to pull up this cover like that. Come on. And here we get our idler. Let me check condition. Condition like require cleaning. We'll use another stick to do that. really hope that these guys didn't put any residue here. Otherwise, it would be a problem. Okay, let's see how much grease is here. And let's clean up the plastic piece. You see, here is a big difference between Nakamichi or between Nakai regular and this one. It has specific part here, which will reduce the vibrations from the motor. Okay, let's clean this guy. Okay, let me see what we get. Okay, it's better. I believe I need another round to clean up either. It still works fine. I didn't mention any slipping. I would replace it if it will get worse. I would prefer original idler over the no-name idler. You see how dark it is. Just for the case because it's make more round and will produce less wow and flutter. Okay, should be good now. So we have it assembled, closed, everything works. Don't like this part. Should go better. Come on. Okay. Now everything is clear. Assembled. That's how it should look like. It's a good shape. Now we will rotate this wheel back to close the cover. This really works in this generation. It really pushes the tape. So this is two belts. I will just trash them. They can be used anymore. Next part would be big assembling everything back in the reverse order. I hope you will enjoy it.